why do we sing together as a church? You know, I've spent my life in search of this answer. And God continues to teach me reason after reason. But in Acts 4, we just see one example. Here we find the early church in a vulnerable state. The enemy is doing everything in its power to snuff it out before it can even get off the ground. In the midst of persecution and the threat of torture and death, these people didn't pray for protection. No, instead they prayed for boldness, boldness to continue preaching the gospel. Now that's what they prayed. Now let's talk about how they prayed. It says that they lifted up their voices and prayed with one accord. Now that phrase "with one accord" is used several times to describe the early church, and as a worship leader I find it very significant. See, the Greek word used here is homothumaden. It's made up of two Greek words that means to rush along, which is tempo, and unison, which is pitch. Both of these are musical theories. Matter of fact, in order to define this word, the Greeks used musical harmony to describe what it means. See, harmony is the ability for different people to sing different notes at the same time to create one sound. So when we sing together as a church, we sing the same words. We're thinking the same thought, we're praying the same prayer, and we're praising the same God. We each have different voices, tones, and ranges, but we're creating one sound together. We're exercising this phrase with one accord. Music gives us the ability to do this. That's why we use drums to keep us in time. That's why we use instruments to keep us in pitch. That's why we sing prayers and scriptures to meditate together as one. Listen to what happened when the church lifted up their voices with one accord. After this prayer, the meeting place shook and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit. Then they preached the word of God with boldness. All the believers were united in heart and mind, and they felt what they owned was not their own, so they shared everything they had. The apostles testified powerfully to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and God's great blessing was upon them all.